motion is rejected, the existing salary shall prevail. So a motion to approve means we approved it. A motion to deny means that we rejected it. So I'm not sure. It doesn't say we have to make a motion to reject. It just says we have to, as a council, reject it, which would mean we turned it down.
Well, much like the previous item, that motion to reject failed. So in this case, if it comes out to be 3-3, which we shall see, but at that point in time, it's a null decision.
Sure.
Both would be either a motion to approve if it's 3-3 or a motion to reject if it's 3-3. It's a null motion.
Sure. So the first one is going to be, even though we rejected it, or no, it was no. No vote, then it's voted.
No action.
No action. So the same here.
Because the council failed to reject in the 30 days. So they until you get to the 30 days. All right. Any further discussion?
Yes, Chairman.
Yes, go ahead.
So for the clerk's salary, am I saying it right that it would be about a 35% increase?
Through the chair, it would be a significant increase in some of the consideration that went into what other full-time clerks make for their capacity. And if we were to hire a director to run that organization, what would we pay that director? And so when they looked at the comparables of what that would be, they came up with the following determination. And then they thought that it would be appropriate because it is a pretty large number that they would break it up over a two-year span.
Any further?
I was just curious if the Compensation Commission put any thought or did any research into the residential household income, if they've received a 35% increase over the past, since ultimately they're the ones that are going to be paying for it.
I would say that the financial health of the city was a strong determination in giving raises this time. And as far as what the median income is of a resident, I'll say that that was taken into consideration in its entirety. However, the demographics of the community are part of what our comparables are, and we look at it in what they're saying would be comparable to us.
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Mayor.
I'd just like to point out that I did not attend this meeting. However, I did send a letter of support from one individual, and that was Clerk Bauer. Over the years, if you look at her pay compared to other clerks in the city and the amount of staff that they have, is quite significantly less. Over the years, the increases went down because the Compensation Commission wasn't sure what the council wanted, and you know, if they gave too much, it was gonna get looked. But over that time, our clerk department has fallen drastically below of what our department heads and our directors. The directors just received a new contract, which their first raise was 9%. Most of our directors make pretty good money, and it's still a significant amount more than our clerk. And our clerk is a department head and a director, in my opinion. And for the amount of work that her office does with the staff and everything, even with this, I think she's still underpaid. But that's just my opinion, and that's that, and the note that I sent to the Compensation Commission.
Mr. Hopper, do you have the comparables?
I don't have them with me, but I can email them to everybody.
I can.
Yeah.
No, what I wanted to, the mayor brought up a point, and I believe one of the things that the Compensation Commission does do is look at comparables. You brought that up. So I believe the clerk of Westland makes almost double, or maybe at least as significant as you mentioned. It's something.
Mr. Chairman, through the chair, most people's deputy makes quite a bit more than our clerk.
There are several. Actually, I've turned down deputy clerk jobs to go work in other cities for six figures because I love my job and I want to stay here. But it is hard when I keep getting asked.
Through the chair. One of the other things that came up in the Compensation Committee is the people that are going to take these elected positions, there has to be a financial reward for them doing that. Ms. Bauer, for example, brings up a very valid point that she could have
if this motion fails.
Yes.
I didn't make the modifications to the agenda, but it would be probably more clear, similar to the last one, more than the intent was to reject, then that probably would have been more clear. In this case, different members made the motion to approve, certainly they were the first to be recognized.
Okay, I'm just curious, has the council ever turned down the raises in the past?
Yeah.
Yes, sure, yes.
Can you tell me the verbiage that was used when they were turned down? Was it a motion to approve, was it a?
Chair, I believe the last one that I remember was for the mayor position, in the last, when I was on council, and it was a motion to reject.
That is correct, from what I remember.
Certainly, council secretary has all the records from the council.
Mr. Chairman, just to kind of give a little history too, if that's okay. When we came on council 10 years ago, Mr. Johnson was there, it was the third day where the compensation commission made a recommendation, and if nothing was done, it went into effect in 30 days. Our chairwoman at the time said, you know, we should at least make this transparent to let us know, or let everybody else know what the recommendation was of the compensation commission, and we should vote on whether we think it should be granted or not. That's when we first got on, I know that's how it kind of took place, and that's how we started bringing it out, to at least show people that we were for it or against it. But to deny somebody, we had to specifically say, we reject.
I don't think anyone got a raise that year.
Mr. Chair, you're right.
I don't think anybody got a raise that year because of the economy, the state of the city, with $3 million in debt.
Yeah, the first year, that's correct.
All right, is there any further discussion on item 7.15? Hearing none, all in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no.
No.
Roll call, please.
Ms. Swinton?
Yes.
Mrs. Primula?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Here we go.
Ms. Rose?
Yes.
Ms. Daniels?
No.
Mr. Geis?
Yes.
She got it.
Passes 4-2. Item 7.16 is a motion to approve the 2023 Compensation Commission determination for treasurer.
Motion, support.
Motion by Councilwoman Whitten, supported by Councilwoman Grandana. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no.
No.
Roll call, please.
Ms. Swinton?
Yes.
Mrs. Primula?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Ms. Rose?
No.
Ms. Daniels?
No.
Mr. Geis?
Yes. Item 7.17 is a motion to receive and file the 2023 compensation, I'm sorry, a motion to approve the 2023 Compensation Commission determination for the mayor.
Motion, support.
Motion by Councilwoman Whitten, supported by Councilwoman Grandana. Is there any discussion?
Through the chair, if I could also read the compensation committee statement in regards to the mayor. After careful consideration of not only the internal and external comparables, the commission also gave strong consideration to significant successes and achievements that have been realized by Mayor Rowley. Those successes include significant fund balance, budget, strong economic developments, including industrial, commercial, and residential, and then all the city's collective bargains that were completed at the time, strong working relationship with the council, as well as strong employee morale.
Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no.
No.
Roll call, please.
Three cool and grand openings.
Mrs. Primula?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Ms. Rose?
No.
Ms. Daniels?
No.
Mr. Geis?
Yes. Motion passes 4-2. Item 7.18 is a motion to approve 2-year renewal of workers' compensation excess insurance policy at Midwest Employers for the period of January 1st, 2024 through December 31st, 2025 for an annual amount not to exceed $104,540 in total. 7.19 is a motion to approve solicitation request from Knights of Columbus All Saints Council Number 4872 to hold a Tootsie Roll Drive March 22nd through March 24th.
Motion. Support.
Motion by Councilwoman Daniels, supported by Councilwoman Whitton. Rose. Jumping on the Tootsie Roll bandwagon, everybody said yes. Point. And that is a sign that warmer weather is just around the corner.